Now let me introduce Jorge Bravo. Jorge Bravo is director of stenographers at the Senate of Argentina. He's president of the Argentinian Association of Parliamentary Stenographers. He is council member of Intersteno and council member of the Ibero-American Federation of Associations of Stenographers. Next to him, there will be Sergio Salinas. He's member of Stenographer's Office at the Senate of Argentina. He's a council member of the Ibero-American Federation of Associations of Stenographers and council member of the Argentinian Association of Parliamentary Stenographers. I now leave the floor to Jorge.
Thank you very much, Carlos. Carlo? Well, good morning, good afternoon. The first part of this presentation is a video of the coalition in the past to fashion the future, the present of the Argentinian Congress Library. The first part, it is a video, then I will do some reflections of the past, the present, and the future of our profession.
The Library of Congress of the Argentine Nation was created in 1859. Its purpose is to assist legislators, collaborate with official and private bodies, provide free information, documentation, and advice to the public in general. It is depository of a cultural heritage consisting in 3 million bibliographical pieces and more than 7,000 titles of journals, magazines and periodical issues of Argentina and from abroad. It has interchange with 600 national and foreign institutions. Since the first shorthand work in Argentina in 1818, thanks to Bernardo de Victorica, who was also a professor when he was appointed at the Congress, stenography in Argentina paved the way of enrichment with different valuable contributions, till we reach Miguel Palant, who was a defender of the demotic writing and built an important library consisting in 417 items, such as books and magazines, dealing with shorthand writing. With the passing of time, he would donate this material to the Library of the National Congress, which was kept up to nowadays and has been enriched by more items and by a digitalized catalog to be consulted by internet. This material, containing invaluable documentary content, is permanently consulted by shorthand professionals, students, researchers, both from Argentina and from abroad. Miguel Palanque is a fundamental name in the shorthand world, owing to the spreading he made of it, and because of the selection criteria used by him for his collection and his investigations. For the Argentine Association of Parliamentary Stenographers, it is an honor to share the Miguel Palanque heritage of the Library of Congress of the Argentine Nation at this 49th Congress of Intersteno 2013 in Ghent, Belgium. A fundamental bibliographical corpus for the shorthand profession, a skill of science, an alphabet which, as well as other writings, also invites to give the minimum detail a place in the adventure.
Sur les murs de photos, sans regret, sans mélodie. La porte est claquée, Jorge est barré.
I'd like to thank you for the possibility of addressing you at this Intersteno Congress, the most important world meeting of professionals in the use of words. This presentation was conceived during the visit of our president, Mr. Fausto Ramondelli, to the shorthand writers of the Argentine Senate and to the Library of the National Congress, one of the most important libraries in the country. This library has a section that is called a special collection, that includes the Palanque collection, which, as we have recently seen in the video, consists exclusively of shorthand books and magazines from 22 countries. There we can find bibliographical treasures of all time, such as the minutes of the congresses that the International Federation of Shorthand Writers held in Paris in 1989 and in 1900, or in Madrid, Spain, in 1912. Books that reflect the theories and thought of great shorthand masters as Gabelsberger, Noé, Pittman, Greg, Larralde from Argentina, Duployer, etc. Documents, pictures, amazing data, championships, results, magazines with theoretical contributions, and devices that in many cases are still updated. We can mention the magazines La Taquigrafía from Brazil, El Mundo Taquigráfico from Spain, Boletín from Spain, La Revista degli Stenografi, Lettura Stenografica from Italy, Taquidáctilo from Turkey, etc. As our time is limited, our wish today is to inform you about the existence of this library and tell you, within the framework of this Congress of the International Federation, that we have begun with the development of projects for the microfilming and digitalization of shortened books and magazines, a work that is being carried out according to the regulations of the Argentine legislation. Thus, this collection will no longer be restricted to Argentine researchers. People from any country of the world will be able to consult it. So, this historical heritage will be very useful for all our colleagues from other countries who otherwise may have never seen these books. Besides, our intention is to make agreements with other libraries in order to share catalogues and be able to make online consultations. We'd like to have the support of the International Federation to achieve this objective. We all know that there is a specialized library in Germany, and we have been informed that there is also a short-term library in Rio de Janeiro, in Brazil, which is very important for the parliament of this country. I insist, we want all these libraries to get together and share their catalogues, and that any of us may have access to them from any part of the world. Therefore, I invite all of you to join this project, which I am sure will be a success. Dear colleagues, today we have a society that is very different from that of the previous centuries. Times have changed. The world has changed. Our profession has changed. And what today is new, tomorrow will be old. Many of us have experienced many changes. Not so long ago, our professional used pencils, pieces of papers, and typewriters. Years passed, and everything remained the same. Today, nothing is the same. Our youngest colleagues know it very well. Technology is making progress. Books are digitalized, and they are e-books, computers, notebooks, netbooks, tablets, multimedia, and video conferences. Maybe we should remember McLuhan's words. He has left us a theoretical framework that allows us to study and understand the nature of this new media that have completely changed the history of mankind's communications. We all know that our profession is not the same as yesterday's. Or, most importantly, it must not be the same as yesterday's. We, as professionals, have the obligation to change if we want the future to be ours. What is our job? Making the shortened version, the journal, the stenographic account, report, or whatever other name we may want to call it. Above all, we have to understand that this is nothing but information, and that nowadays information is power. Today's information is valuable today, because tomorrow it is already old. That is the reason why our job has to comply with quality requirements, including a speed in the distribution of information. In the Argentine Senate, for example, we are proud to be certified to ISO 9001 quality management standards, since we upload journals to internet 2.5 hours after sessions are adjourned, regardless of whether they have lasted for 5, 10, 15, or 20 hours. You may wonder, this man has come from Argentina to talk about old books, and now he speaks of changes, of the future, of modernity. Yes, my friends. And I believe I am not crazy, because there is no future without history. I simply dream of a future which we have to build with our own hands. It is our duty to make this dream come through. In any case, as Lennon said, you may say I am a dreamer, but I am not the only one.
Jorge. Yes, now you can see, as Lennon said, Daniel got, well, I know it is not professional to do so, but it was too nice to not to let everybody note it. When you say as Lennon said, he got as Lenin said, and he wrote as Lenin said. Then he got the quotation, and he corrected his mistake. That's why everybody was laughing.
I don't know the opinion of Lenin of the stenography. John Lennon. I know that in the International Federation there are many colleagues who agree with me and already working in this direction. We have to be convinced that we need to learn from our rich history, from the experience of our ancestors, and to keep up to date with any progress made in our profession. They are in the past, the future was born, which is the present we are now living in. We only have to continue the past outlined by our ancestors, develop our profession with passion, and put it on track for the future. The only thing we have to be convinced of is that nobody will do things for us. The means for registration may change, but the final product of our work remains the same. The publication of debates, a fundamental element of democracy. Nowadays, thanks to the internet, any citizen in the world can read what was delayed in a faraway parliament almost in real time. The means is unimportant. Shorthand, stenography, stenotype, speech recognition, or any other technique that may appear in the future. Our challenge is to take control of new technologies. Let us accept this challenge, this wonderful adventure. We are privileged to have an international federation that has always been an example for everyone and that has always been in the vanguard. With our commitment, with the help of the Federation, and above all, with the training of young professionals who will develop our project, the future is bound to be successful. Let us not fear the future. Let us not fear technology. Let us not fear young people. On the contrary, if we work together with them, we will have all the means to make our profession more popular and recognized. The future is not what is going to happen, but what we are going to do. Let us do it together. Jorge Luis Borges said, "The future depends on us. And there is only one thing we know, that it will be different from the present. Let us not be afraid of the future. Let us build the future together. What we are doing here in Ghent, maybe without realizing it, is already a new stage. History supports us, the present helps us, and the youth encourages us to move forward. The future belongs to us. The future has begun. This is our message, which can be summarized in the following short 1 minute long video. Thank you. CD with the video presentation. Thank you.
Thank you, Jorge. He said he doesn't speak English, but he has made the presentation in English. But and he has also added some extra information in English. So we can have a conference on what does it mean to speak languages. But this is not the topic of today. Thank you, Jorge. If you have any questions for Jorge, we can answer them now. While you are thinking of having or not having a question for him, I'd like to stress the importance of having a library, a virtual library of on the history of stenography. This is something which is great, and I don't know if there is already one. But we have one question. Yes, Lida.
Thank you. Well, this just comes up in my head, and I should discuss it, of course, with Marlene and the board of Interinfo Nederland. We have on our the website of Interinfo Nederland has a shorthand museum. And it started with the legacy of Sees van Beurden, former Intersteno president, IPRS coordinator, etc. And after his death, his family donated all his, let's say, shorthand books, old books, etc. to Interinfo Nederland. And I know he published some on the internet, but there is more, and it's all. I think it's on the attic of Jan den Halder. Could that be, and we don't know where to go with it. Could that be added to your library? Just an idea. I don't know whether other people agree with it, Dutch, but It just came up.
The idea of this project is exactly to put this library in conjunction with the other experiences which are in the world. By the means of a digital archive which could put together library already existing and other that we will learn about.
My name is Cornelia Tomachu. I was a shorthand teacher of the shorthand stenographers of the chamber, and I think it will be better to discuss it first in the board of the Intersteno group Nederland before we can discuss to give it to another country. We have to discuss it first because it was a personal belonging. So, Francis van Bergen. I don't think he will agree to give it away.
Without the Dutch method.
Okay, something hot is coming up.
I don't know if it has already said, but in Italy we have Accademia Riprandi, which has a very important library with about 5,000 books. At the same time in Florence there were another important library, which is now transferred from Florence to Trento, or better is Rovereto, where there is an important library of other important things of arts and so on. This gives me the possibility to answer the question of the lady of Netherlands. The second library in Florence was founded by Giulietti, who was the chief of the reporting service at the Italian Parliament in the first part of the last century. He earned a lot of money, and since he had no son, he left this library to a foundation. The foundation now has no more money, so they found the opportunity to transfer this to another community who is able to keep it. I think that the point is to keep all these things available to everybody. So Accademia has already done a list of all contents on the website. One can consult the title, the author, and so on. And I think that the idea of our Argentine friends is to have a net of all these libraries, and so I suppose that everybody can join without thinking about the past persons, who, in my opinion, will be very glad to see that their work is still useful.
Okay, thank you. I don't want to add anything else, just to stress that the idea is that of a virtual library, meaning that those who want to keep the materially the books can do that. What is shared is the opportunity from Argentina, from Australia, from the North Pole to consult those books. Okay. Are there any other comments? Okay. Thank you, Jorge. Your presentation made many discussions.
Thank you.